Hi everyone, very nice to have you here. We're gonna need a strap or block and blocks if you need. If you don't have a strap, just get a belt or anything that has that function. I'm gonna go right into it. We're gonna start in a sitting down position, hips into the heels, hands into the thighs, into the knees, just closing your eyes. So taking a big inhalation and exhalation, connecting to the breath, inhaling all the way up to the top of the head. Exhale all the way down to the hips, to the core. Again, inhaling all the way up through the spine into the top of the head. And in the exhalation, allow the shoulders to sink away from the ears. Allow the body to feel heavy into the mat. Just keep going. Inhaling, exhaling. Open up the rib cage. And exhale, close the ribs. And feel a little contraction in the lower belly. Just really bring the awareness into the breath. Try to close the door from every thought that goes on in our mind right now. Preparing the mind and the body for the practice. Bringing the awareness into this very present moment. Just touching in with your face, feeling that the eyes are soft, the nose, the mouth, the jaw. Your body is without tension, unnecessary tension. And throughout the class, just keep checking, probably in your face, if you tighten up your fingers, your toes, and try to come back into this sense of softness and relaxation. Okay, slowly blink your eyes open. Just place the hands in front of you. You're gonna start on all four today. So hands directly underneath the shoulders, knees underneath the hips. Spread the fingers and already press away from the mat, feeling the stomach towards the spine. In the inhalation, we're going to lift the tailbone up, release the thumb in the chest down, shoulder towards the hips, look up. Exhale, squeeze our thighs round the spine, chin to chest, fire up the core. Inhale to open up through the spine, bring the shoulders away from the ears, look up. And exhale to round the spine, inflating the back, chin to chest, stomach strong. Inhale, opening up into cow shape through the spine, and exhale to round. Inhale to come back to center, flip the hands of the fingers up towards the knees. Same things, inhale, open up the spine, shoulders away from the ears, look up. Exhale, round the spine, keep pressing the wrists down, strong arms. Inhale to open up, arch the spine, look up. And exhale to round, core strong, inflating the back. One more, inhale to open up. Exhale, bring the tailbone under, round the spine, chin to chest. Coming back to center one more time, flip the hands again. One last inhale, open up into cow shape. This time, half the heels towards the hips, look up. Exhale to round the spine, press the feet down, lift the knees off the mat. Inhale to open up into cow shape, half the heels towards the hips. Exhale, press the feet down, round the spine, squeeze and thighs, inflate the back. One more, inhale to open up. And exhale to round, stay here for five, strong core. Four, three, two, one. Release the knees down, open them up a little bit more, hip circles. Maybe we're closing your eyes, softening through the shoulders, the hips, massaging your body, every single vertebra, the ribs, let them open and release. Doing anything that feels good right now. And then slowly, exhale, close the knees slightly, bring the hips towards the heels. Right away, inhaling, rounding the spine, forward into all four. Exhale, lift tail, chest and chin, arch the spine back into the heels, chin comes last. Inhaling, squeezing your thighs, rounding the spine, forward into all four. Exhale, lift tail, chest chin, arch your spine back into the heels. One more inhale, wave forward. This time allow the hips to come down, wiggle a little bit from side to side. And exhale, bring it back into the heels. We're gonna come up into all fours one more time. We're gonna inhale the right arm up into a twist. And exhale, bring it down. I'm gonna take the left leg out to the side, left arm reaches up. If you can, see if you can wanna grab the opposite inner thigh and keep reaching both shoulders up towards the ceiling. Breathe into the spine, into the chest. One more. Good. Left hand reaches down, right hand comes up, inhale. And exhale, release the right hand down. We're gonna bend the left leg and just push forward or side and back if you can to open up the hips. Now we're gonna sink the hips down towards the heel and bring it up. And then down and up. Now reach the hips down, the fingers forward, walk both fingers towards the right side. And then lift up into a half wild thing. And slowly exhale, coming back. And one more time, walk the hands towards the right side, open up. Exhale, core strong. Maybe walk the hands a little further away and lift the left leg up. And down. And up. And down. Up. Squeeze the heel towards the hips, open up. If you can, grab the foot and then press the foot into the hands to open up. Slowly, you're gonna release the leg, bring the left hand forward, right arm forward. Gonna exhale, knee to elbow, and then lift up. Round, and up, and then round, up. Now squeeze the heel towards the hips. If you can grab the foot, point the foot into the hands to open up. Try again. Slowly let go of the leg, squeeze the knee towards the chest. Simply release. Wiggle the hips a little bit from side to side. And then other side. So left arm comes up, inhale. Exhale, taking down, thread the needle. Right leg reaches out, right arm reaches up. If you can, grab the left inner thigh and reach both shoulders up towards the ceiling. Breathe into it. Open up the spine to the twist. Slowly, right hand reaches down, left arm comes up, inhale. And exhale, reach your left hand down. Bend into the right leg to open up the right hip. And then reach the hips down, and up. And down, and up. And down, fingers forward, both hands towards the left side. Lift the hips and chest, halfway up. Exhale, slowly release that. One more time, open up, halfway lifting. Now bring the stomach in, walk the left hand away from a little bit, reach your right leg up, and down, and up, and down, and up. Squeeze the heel towards the hips, if you can grab the foot and then point the foot into the hands. Release, try to keep the balance, reach your right arm forward, leg reaches back. Left arm forward, inhale, exhale, round the spine, inhale to open up, exhale, round the spine, inhale to open up, exhale, squeeze the heel towards the hips, if you can grab the foot and then point the foot into the hands to open up into tiger. Slowly let go of the leg, knee to chest, knee to nose, sorry, and then release. Wiggle the hips a little bit from side to side. Hands strong, tuck toes under, and lift the hips up into downward facing dog. Breathe in for a second, maybe pedal the knees, if they feel good. And keep spreading the fingers into the mat. Keep reaching with the heels towards the mat, bending the knees if you need, elongating through the spine. Tailbone reaching up towards the ceiling. We're gonna inhale, lift up into the toes, rounding the spine forward into high planted state. And very slowly release the knees down and then melt into the tummy. Keep the hands where they are next to the chest. We're gonna start with the top of the head, the nose, the mouth, the chin, opening up into baby cobra. And exhale, slowly release down. One more time, top of the head, the nose, the mouth, the chin, contracting in the back of the neck. Actively and slowly release down. One more, opening up through the throat. And exhale, slowly release down. Fingertips into the side of the chest. We're gonna inhale, press them at the width to come up. Wiggle a little bit into the top, creating more space. And exhale to release all the way down. Walk the fingers a little bit closer to you if you can. Press them at the way. Wiggle into the top, creating more space between the ribs and the hips. And exhale to release all the way down. One last. Inhale, press them at the way and come up. Strong core, strong glutes. Open up the chest, reach it up, open the throat. And slowly exhale to melt and release. Slide the elbows forward in front of you. Squeeze through the glutes, engage the legs. In the inhalation, we're going to slide the elbows towards the chest, open up the chest. Exhale, slide the elbows away, stomach to spine. Inhale, slide the elbows toward the chest, hug the shoulder blades together. Exhale, slide the elbows away, stomach to spine. One more, inhale to slide the elbows, open up the chest. Now stretch the arms forward into the fingertips. See if you can lift both legs up. Now keep this position and reach the arms up. For 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And then slowly release. We go the hips a little bit from side to side. One more time. So have the palms of the hands facing towards each other. So the shoulders are nice and open. Bring the tailbone down towards the mat, engage the core, engage the legs, 1, 2, 3, reach up. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, release, wiggle through the hips. Last one, we're gonna make it a little bit easier, tuck the arms, tuck the shape. One more time, engaging through the core, through the hips, 1, 2, 3, reach up. Slide the elbows away from the ears. Interlace the fingers behind the back. Press the hands away, squeeze the heels together. For 5, 4, Shalabhasana, 3, 2, and 1. Slowly release down. Hands into the side of the shoulder and the chest. Inhale to open up into up dog. Exhale, press back. Down, we face it up. Breathe into it, breathe into the spine. Feel the tailbone reaching away from the top of the head. Inhale, you're gonna wave forward into high plank. Exhale, bend the knees, lift tail, chest and chin, arch your spine back. Downward facing dog. Inhale, waving forward into high plank. This time allow the hips to come down into support, left dog, look up. Exhale, lift with the hips and take it back, downward facing dog. One more, inhale, waving forward. High plank, round it through the spine. Hips down, support, left dog, press them at the way, open up the chest. Exhale, take it back, downward facing dog. Inhale, way forward into high plank. Exhale, release the hips down, support left dog. This time, point the right foot, three-legged dog, right leg reaches up. Open up the hips and bend it. Stretch the neck, square up the hips, round the spine, knee to nose. Release the right foot down between the hands. We still into the toes of the back foot, back leg. Just move forward and back. Allowing the hips to release. Then we're gonna tap the knee down and then inhale, reach it up. Exhale down, inhale up. Open it up into the left hip flexor and up. One more. Down and up. Release the knee down, the foot down, squeeze into the inner thighs. Left arm comes up, inhale, exhale, reach towards the same side as the knee that is in front. Maybe looking up. If you want more stretch, you can try to bind the elbow, inhale, and exhale, take it to the side. Inhale to come up into the hips a little bit. Bring the knee in slightly, and then create enough space for the shoulder to come as close as possible to the knee. Then press the knee into the shoulder, hands in namaste. Either just stand here, or tucking toes under, lifting the knee up. If you want, see if you can find the bind, and look back. Slowly release. Now start walking both hands. So come up with the hips a bit more. Reach with the left hand towards the calf of the ankle. Right arm comes up. Inhale. Exhale. Reach with the hips forward. Inhale to come back. Exhale to leg take. Reaching with the right hand towards the foot. One more. Inhale up. And exhale. Reach forward. Hips reaches down. Both hands come forward on the inside of the foot. Walk the right foot up to the side a little bit, tuck toes under, come up. And then lift the hips up, jump the left foot in a little bit, modify pyramid pose. Press the hands down into the mat, round the spine, so we can circle the right leg straight back into three-legged dog. Release the right foot down. Inhale, wave forward into high plank. Knees, chest and chin into the mat, stay here. Roll forward into the tummy, cobra. Tuck toes under, press yourself back down, releasing dog. Inhale, wave forward into high plank. Exhale, release the hips down into supported up dog. Look up. Point the left foot, three-legged dog. Open up the hips and bend the knees. Ground into the hands, into the foot. Stretch the legs, square up the hips. Left knee to nose. Release the left hand between the hands. Move forward and back. Engage in the right leg. Allowing the hips to sink down towards the mat. Inhale, tuck the knee down towards the mat. And then lift it up, keeping the hips as low as you can. Tap it down. And then up. And down. And up. One more. Down. And up. Release the knee and the foot down, squeeze the thighs, right arm comes up, inhale, exhale, leg bend towards the left side. If you want, grab the opposite elbow and reach it to the side. You'll be looking up. Inhale to come back. Now bring the knee in a little bit, so the shoulder comes really close to the knee. Then press the knee to the shoulder, to twist more, hands in namaste. If you can, tuck toes under and lift up. If you want, take a bind. Slowly release in the position. Now reaching both hands towards the back. Right hand into the calf, into the ankle. Left arm comes up. Inhale, exhale, both hips forward towards the left foot. Inhale to come up. Exhale, reach. Inhale, up. And exhale, reach. Pulling in both directions, forward and back. Slowly take both hands into the inside of the foot, walking the left foot out to the side. Tuck toes under, lift the hips up. Modify pyramid pose. Press the hands down around the spine and circle the left leg straight back. Three-legged dog. Take the left foot down into down dog. Inhale, wave forward into high plank. Knees, chest, and chin. Either stand here, if you feel you can go more, you can try to interlace the fingers behind the back and reach them up. Slowly hands down, roll forward, cobra, up dog, exhale, downward facing dog. Then walking the hands back towards the feet. Open up the feet, hip distance apart, toes out to the side, and sink the hips down, Malasana. Walk the fingers forward, wiggle the hips. Attach the left shoulder into the left leg, right hand into the right knee, open up the right knee out to the side. Inhale, coming back to center, right shoulder into the right leg. Left hand into the knee, open it up. sustain to Malasana, sitting the hips down, the top of the head towards the ceiling, the legs active, the knees actively pushing out to the side. Slowly hands down, lift the hips up, square up the feet, inhale, lengthen the spine, look up, exhale, have the elbows forward fold. Wiggling a little bit from side to side if you feel like it. Feel the top of the head heavy, the elbows heavy, the tailbone actively reaching up. Stomach pulling towards the spine, creating enough space for the spine to release down. Release the hands, you're gonna cup the heels, so just grab the ankles, inhale, and exhale, squeeze yourself a little bit closer to the legs. The neck is completely relaxed. Slowly release the feet, soft knees, start rolling up to standing, all the way up. Good. From here, we're gonna grab the strap or whatever you have. We're gonna start with the hands shoulder distance apart. So they're not very wide, they're literally shoulder distance. We're gonna inhale, reach the arms up, on this side, reach the arms up, and then bring the hand just a little bit behind the head. Keep the head straight, squeeze into the ribs, into the core, into the glutes. And then slowly release down, in and up, take the hands slightly back, squeeze everything in, and then slowly release. Now open the arms a little bit more, not very open, a little bit more. Inhale to come up, allow the hands to reach a little bit further back, open up the chest, keep squeezing the ribs in, and then slowly release. Inhale to come up, open up through the armpits, through the chest, ribs in, core and glutes strong, and then release. Now open up the arms as far as you need. We're gonna inhale the arms up, exhale, round the back, inhale up, and exhale forward. If it's easy, you can close the hands. If it's hard, you can take the hands further apart. Up, and down, up. Down and up, down. I'm gonna take the arms out to the side and back and opposite side and back, left and back, and then right and back. Okay, release a little bit. Now you're gonna place one end of the strap into the back of one foot and reach the opposite hand up. So my strap is quite small. Now you're gonna bend the knee and lift the tailbone up arch the spine. Now you're gonna start to stretch, make sure that the elbows reach in. You're gonna start to stretch the elbows out, open up into the thoracic spine, and then slowly release. One more. So bend the legs, pull the strap away from you, and keep pulling it until you can. And then slowly release. Okay, that's enough for now. Take the strap away from you, bring the hands into the hips, hip circles. Nice and wide into one direction. And then the other. Feet a little bit closer together, placing the hands with the fingers towards the ribs. Squeeze the elbows in, press the hips forward. Now lift up into the chest. And if you can, releasing the head back. And then slowly release. You can either do this one more time, if you can. Fingers interlaced, so hands interlaced, index fingers out. I'm gonna reach up towards the ceiling, looking up at the thumbs, lift up, bring the hips forward and chest up. Exhale, standing back bend. And then slowly coming back, ribs in. And exhale, release. Grounding to the feet for a second. Coming back to the breath. Good. One more time, feet in distance apart. This time, we're going to bend the knees, Uttanasana position. Staying here for five, four, two, one. Neutralize the fingers behind the head. We're gonna inhale, puff the chest, arch your spine, press the head into the hands, look up. Exhale, stretch the legs, elbows in. One more time, pressing the head into the hands. One more, like this. Open up through the elbows, the chest, pressing the head back, arch your spine. Exhale to round, pressing the head into the hands. Let go of the fingers, cut the arms, open up, inhale, shoulders on top of the hips. Exhale, round the spine, give yourself the biggest hug. One more, inhale to open up, cup the chest, arch the spine, opposite arm on top, round the spine. Last one, interlace the fingers, inhale to open up, arch the spine, bring the hands back. Exhale, stretch legs, round the spine, stomach towards the spine, spread the shoulder blades. Bend the knees, inhale to open up. Exhale, round. One last, inhale to open up. Slide the elbows towards the hips. Interlace the fingers behind the back. Press the hands out to open up the chest. Exhale, forward fold with the fingers interlaced. I'm sweating. Hope you are too. Top of the head heavy. Weight into the toes. Breathing into the spine, into the shoulder blades, into the armpits. Slowly release the hands forward, bring the heels together, squat down. Now bring the knees into the armpits, just squeezing the elbows out to the side, whatever version you can. Round the spine, lift up. Bakasana. One, two, three, jump back. Inhale to open up into up dog. Exhale to press back into downward facing dog. Calm the breath, stand here for a second. Right leg reaches up, one leg very facing dog, open up the hips and bend the knee. Now stretch the leg. We're gonna come forward with the chest, try to reach with the foot towards the head, like a scorpion tail. Opposite round the spine, knee to nose. Release the right foot down between the hands and then come up into a high lunge. Inhale here, exhale, tuck the arms and open up the chest. Connect to the core, press them out the way to come up. Exhale, arch. Press them out the way to come up. Exhale, arch. Inhale to come up. Now right arm under the left. Go Mukhasana the arms, inhale here. Exhale, sink the hips down. Release the knee down, we're going to inhale, reach up, touching the ribs from the hips. Exhale, take a back bend. Inhale to come back, come up into high lunge, step forward a little bit, and then shift the weight forward, reaching with the hands, coming up into warrior three. Squeezing the inner thighs, squaring up the hips. Bending the front leg, oops, and reach back into warrior two. Reverse, reaching, stretching the front leg. Inhale here, exhale, Trikonasana. Hands into the ankle, go into a block, and then squeeze the inner thighs and reach up. Bend the left arm, grab the right inner thigh, and then almost like line into the left elbow, left arm. Look down, release the arm, bend the front leg, reach with the fingers forward, and lift the left leg up. Half moon. Now bend the leg and first squeeze the heel towards the hips. If this is easy, push the foot into the hands with a little back bend. Release the foot, bend the front knee, come back into warrior two. Elbow to knee or hands all the way down, shoulder to knee, knee to shoulder. If you can, take a bind, bring the tailbone under, open up, stretching the front leg if you want. These are all options. Really make sure that you do anything that feels right for you. Bending the knee, both hands release down into the inside, squaring the hips, squeezing inner thighs. Right arm comes up into a twist. Release the right hand down, lift the hips up, walk fingers and toes towards the side. Heels out, toes in, inhale to lengthen the spine. Exhale, long spine to come down. Inhale to roll through the spine. And exhale, long spine to come down, releasing in whatever version you like of this posture. Whatever feels good right now, go for it. If you feel like you need an inversion, you can come up into straddle cracks or into a tripod and stand. Feel free. If you're gonna slide down to a side split. Slowly, wherever you are, come back and then walk the hands towards the front. Release the left knee and foot down. Open up the right foot out to the side. Hands into the knees, wiggle the hips. And then reach back with the right hand, tuck toes under. Squeeze the heel in like you're squeezing an orange. And then point the foot into the hand to open up the chest. Exhale, bring the heel towards the hips. So if you can't grab the foot, you can use the strap. It now really stays so active into the left leg. Good. Let it go and keep it there. And then change the hands, grab the left foot with the left hand, inhale. And exhale, one more time, bring it towards the hips. Allow the hip flexor to open up. If you feel good, inhale here, open up the chest, exhale, back bend. Inhale to come back, then release the left leg down. We're gonna come up into pyramid, open up through the chest, to the right leg. Now press another way, lift the right foot up, bend the leg, and go down into pigeon. Prepare the fingertips into the side of the leg. Square the hips. We're going to inhale, lift the hips up just a little bit. And exhale, release down. One more. Up. And down. And up. Pelvic floor is strong. Lift up and down. Now if you need to stretch more into the hips, you can take the right foot out 90 degrees. Keep it 90 degrees. Keep the hips straight. And then release down. Breathing into it, into this place of tension. Okay, slowly coming back. Bring the heel closer to the hips. That's gonna make it a little bit easier. So if you want, you can bring the strap and strap the back foot. If you don't need it, you're just gonna keep the foot towards the hips. Maybe coming up into mermaid. If you have the foot strapped, you can see if you can reach the left elbow up, reach the right arm up. Now you're gonna press the elbows up and in towards each other and walk the hands back and then bring the foot towards the head. If you don't need a strap, you can place like a little shelf for the foot to come up. Bring the other arm, inhale and exhale. Releasing the foot down, releasing the head down, and then lift yourself up into downward facing dog. Walk the dog a little bit from side to side. And one more time, reaching the right leg up, inhale. Round the spine, knee to nose. Right foot down, step on it to come up. Left knee comes up, left knee goes back. One last time, have the heel towards the hips. Bring the hips forward, really stretching into the left quad. Reach your right arm forward in front of you. Swing the left hand into the inside of the foot. Start kicking the foot into the hands and the right arm up. Reaching towards each other. And now start taking it down for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Release the left leg down. The right arm, the right leg reaches back, one leg down facing dog, shake it off. Shake, shake, shake. Come back into down dog. Walk the knees from side to side. Inhale, rounding forward into high plank. Exhale, reaching back, down facing dog. Inhale, round forward into the high plank. Knees, chest, and chin. So one more time, you can either stay here, you can interlace the fingers behind the back. If this is still okay, you can see if you can squeeze the heel towards the hips. And maybe lift up the chin. Release the hands down. And now open up into cobra. Bring your side back into child's pose for a second. Breathe here. Baby inhaling through the nose, exhaling, mouth open. One more inhale. Good. Hands forward, left toes under, lift the hips up. Downward facing dog. Left leg reaches up, one leg downward facing dog. Open up the hips and bend the knee, press the mat away. Stretch leg. Come forward with the chest and keep reaching the left foot towards the head, scorpion tail. Opposite round the spine, knee to nose. Release the left foot down, strong legs, and come up. Inhale here, exhale, cup the arms, open up the chest. Strong legs to come up, lift the pelvic floor. Exhale, open up. Inhale, up. And exhale, open. Inhale, up. Now swing the left arm underneath the right. And start sinking the hips down. Release the knee and the foot down. Reach up with the elbows with the chest. Exhale, back bend. Inhale to come back. Flat toes under, lift the hips up. Now start leading with the hands, with the elbows, and reach up into warrior three. Bend knee to the front knee. Reach the foot back. Open up, warrior two. Reverse, take it back, and then stretch it through the front leg. Inhale here, exhale, Trikonasana, hands up into the ankle, crown the feet, lift it, right arm up. Now, bind the right arm into the back, grabbing the left inner thigh, and imagine the spine line into the back arm. Slowly releasing the bind, taking the arms forward, lifting up into half moon. Bend the right heel towards the hips, squeeze it in. And then if you can, press the foot into the hands to open up. Slowly let go of the right leg and bring it back. Warrior two. Either here, option one, option two, option three, option four. You pick your best. Bending the front knee, release both hands down, squeeze the inner thighs, lift the left arm up into a twist. Left hand releases down, lift the hips, both hands and feet towards the side, heels out, toes in, and lengthen the spine. Right away, exhale, forward fold into whatever version you like. We'll be bending into the knees as well. Spine away, reaching the hands forward, shaking the head. Enough to come down, left hand the spine, look up. Exhale, walking the hands and the feet towards the front of the mat. Release the knee and the foot down. Open up the left foot up to the side, hands into the knee. Wiggle the hips a little bit. And then reach back, tuck toes under, squeeze your apple, your orange, and then press the foot into the hands to open up. Exhale, bring the foot towards the hips. Active through the right leg. Let go, keep it there. Walk the hands forward, just the right hand into the right foot, inhale, exhale, bring it towards the hips. If you're okay here, you're gonna inhale, lift the chest up, exhale, back bend. Slowly, enough to come back. Release the right foot down, and then lift the hips up into pyramid pose, stay here. Exhale, press the butt away, bend the left leg, and come down into pigeon. So squaring off the hips. Now inhale, lift the hips up through the leg, through the pelvic floor. Exhale, reach it down. Already feel the spine nice and strong, reaching up. And then down. And then up. And then down. I'm gonna reach with the foot forward just because I wanna feel it more into the hips. You don't have to do that. Maybe you even need a block underneath the hip. Squaring the inner, the hips, the inner thighs. Inhale, exhale, forward fold. Slowly lift yourself up. I'm gonna bring the heel closer to the hips one more time, squaring the hips, grabbing your strap if you need. If not, squeezing the heel towards the hip, maybe sliding the foot into the elbow, maybe reaching up into mermaid if you can, or working on grabbing the pinky toe and then reaching the elbow forward to king pigeon. Left arm reaches up, inhale. And exhale, lift the chest up and take a back bend. Slowly let go. Right foot reaches down, left hand reach down, and then lift yourself back into downward facing dog. Wiggle into the knees. Last one, left leg. Reaches up, one leg down, facing dog, open up the hips and bend the knee. Stretch the leg, square up the hips, left knee to nose, left foot down, step on it to come up. Right knee reaches up, right knee reaches back, foot into the hips, bring the hips forward. Left arm comes forward, right hand goes into the inside of the foot, start kicking the foot into the hand and the left arm up. Now keep this resistance as I'm taking it down for 5. Strong back, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Hand reaches down, right foot reaches back, left leg reaches up, 2 legs down, shake it off. Left foot down, down dog, walk the knees one more time. Inhale, round the spine forward, high plank, feet go back, down facing dog. Inhale, round forward into high plank. Exhale, to chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Knees out to the side, bring it down into child's pose. And we wiggle the hips a little bit from side to side and just stay still into the position. From here, I start walking the fingers forward. Squeeze the knees in or close the knees. Hip distance apart. I drop the outer edge of the mat, press the back away, either just forehead or chin and chest, happy pose. If this is easy, you can tuck the toes under as if you can lift the knees off the mat. Release the knees down. Now come up just a little bit. I'm gonna take the right arm on top of the left, like this. Elbows are out, the hips are still 90 degrees. And then I press through the chin on top of the right arm. Slowly come up. Then squat arm, inhale, core to spine, exhale, melt. And then slowly release forward. Arms up to the side, we're gonna take a twist. And then twist it back. Other side. Release. Now can you still strap one more time? If not, tap the arms, squeeze the glutes together, press the tailbone down, squeeze the heels towards the hips. When I grab the head, the feet into the inside, the ankles into the inside, squeeze the feet towards one another, and then press the feet into the hands to come up. And then slowly release everything down. We go through the hips. One more, coming up, engaging everything you need to engage. Squeeze the feet. gonna tap the toes. One more time, squeezing, open up through the chest, and then press the feet into the hands to open up. And then slowly release down, press your hips back into the heels, and then start rolling up through the spine. Press the hands into the knees and create some sort of mini waves sitting here. Just allow the spine to soften. And then come up into the knees, tuck the toes under, fingers towards the ribcage, squeeze the elbows in, press the hips forward. Now walk the hands into the back of the ribs, lift the ribs up, hips forward, chest up. Maybe you just want to stop here if you can, move the hands into the back of the thighs, keep actively pressing the chest up and hips forward. If you can, tap the heels. If you can, release the feet down, Ushtrasana. Slowly, inhale to the back. Exhale, release down, ribs in, spine strong, chin down. Now repeat this one more time. If you are working towards Kapodasana, you can use it into the wall. If not, I'm gonna guide through a little bit more advanced posture. So repeat the same if this was enough for you. If not, inhale, hands into the chest, squeeze the inner thighs towards each other, open up. Exhale, start looking down. If you can, release the hands and touch the mat, and then press the mat away, pushing with the hips forward, creating space through the spine. Now, if this is still okay, you can try to grab the heels, elbows in, Kapodasana. You have to come back, strong legs, ribs in, close it in, sit down. Hips out to the side, hips forward, wiggle the knees from side to side. Now hug the back of the thighs, and now here, next up, spread the spine and weight from the legs. Inhale to come up, hands into the knees. Inhale, lift the chest up. Exhale, squeeze the thighs and round the spine. Strong arms. One more. Inhale to come up. And exhale, squeeze the thighs and round. Now, inhale to come up halfway, pointing the feet, lifting the legs up. Half the basana, squeeze the knees towards the chest. Compressing the front body. Legs down, hands into the side of the hips, lift the hips directly up. Inhale to the back. Exhale, this time we try to squeeze the forehead towards the knees. Feet down, lift up. Inhale to the back, squeeze and touch. Feet down, lift up. Last one. Inhale to come back. See if you can stretch your legs this time. Forehead to knees. And then hands forward. If you can, tilt the elbows into an L shape. And then slowly release down. Gonna bend the legs. Hands into the knees. Hip circle. Spine circle. Supi circles. One direction, and then the other. Coming back, left hand into the right knee, then reach back into a twist, breathing through the spine, and for every exhalation, reach back a little bit more. Inhale to come back to center, exhale other side. Good. Stretch your legs forward. Knees are slightly bent. Last time, walking the hands back, the fingers are out towards the side, sinking the chest down into this kind of position. And then release all the way down into the spine, half the knees into the chest. Wiggle a little bit from side to side. The feet reach down, we're gonna squeeze the inner thighs and come up into bridge. Either you're gonna stay here, if you feel ready for it, place the hands right away into the side of the ears, elbows in towards each other, lift up with the full wheel, Urdhva Dandasana. Keep actively present, not away from each other, lift the hips up, strong arms and legs. And slowly exhale, release them. Repeating the same, so either just a half bridge variation or hands into the side of the ears, lift up. If this is too easy for you, then try to stretch the leg, keep popping forward into the chest, and maybe try to sink the hips down slightly into an alien shape. And then slowly release everything down into the mat. Bend the knees into the chest. Feel the spine heavy into the floor. Release the left leg down, keep the right knee up, inhale. Exhale, take the right knee towards the left side and look back towards the right hand. If you want to increase the twist, you can bend the bottom leg, grab the foot and press it down. Just slowing down the breath. Inhaling, exhaling. Through the spine, through the nose. Slowly coming back to center. We're gonna switch so the left knee comes up, right leg down. Inhale, and exhale, twist. So if you want to increase the squeeze, stretch it, left leg and reach a bit, or reach the left leg away from you, bend the right leg and reach back. And imagine the body softening with the breath, and intentioning the spine to be released. Express that is stagnated into the body, big flying away right now. You have to come back to center, both knees into the chest. Now stretch your legs up and arms up and just shake it off. Shake until you feel you can't even shake anymore. And then find a piece of stillness. Flex the feet, bend the knees, grab the outside of the feet, happy baby. Wiggle a little bit from side to side if it feels good. If not, staying here, allowing the hips to reach down towards the mat, the top of the head reaching into the opposite direction. Doing printing the spine down into the mat. Then the palms of the feet together, interlace the fingers, reach the knees away from you into a little butterfly. And then release the feet down, the hands into the side of the body. Then feet replacing the tailbone underneath the hips. You can either stay here for a while longer, or stretch your legs out into full Shavasana. Inhaling through the nose, exhaling mouth open, and one more, inhaling through the nose, exhale, one last inhale, and exhale. In the body, completely heavy and relaxed. The feet, the legs, the hips. Without tension. Observe the belly rising up and down with the breath. Feel the chest open and release, the arms heavy. The face completely soft. The eyes, the nose, the mouth. The jaw muscles, the tongue. Forehead and temples melting into the side of the face. Enjoying this moment of full relaxation, allowing the healing effect of the practice to take action now. Allow any feelings that has been stuck into the hip flexors, into the chest, into the back, to arise, to be felt. Without any fear, any judgment. With awareness and full consciousness. Feel free to stay into the Shavasana as long as you can, and thanks for practicing with me. I'll see you soon next time.